Hello, this is Cristi. In this video, we will look at how we can create a talking head video in Descript. It's a very common effect that you see all around the web, and you can certainly do it in other applications like Camtasia, Premiere, and any other application that supports masking. But in Descript, it wasn't easy to do this, and it wasn't possible until the new version, the storyboard version, came out and they added a feature that I'm going to show you. So let's have a look at how we can create a talking head video where we have one track. We're going to use multiple tracks in this project, and we have one track showing the screen and another track showing a video camera from a webcam, and then of course audio, but that's not relevant for this video. So in order to create a talking head video, the video camera, the webcam video stream, needs to be separate from the screen video. So they have to be two different tracks in a sequence. And if you are using Descript, you know that it has two recorders. One recorder is like the old one that burns the camera video in a circle in the corner and you can't move it. And the new recorder that's part of the storyboard version that you launch from within the application, that recorder will allow you to record separate tracks. So if you are in Descript, and I have a project here, the blank project in Descript, and you launch the recorder from here, from the top, this recorder actually records in separate tracks. So it allows you to select cameras and screen and all those things, and it records separate tracks. And that is a good thing because it allows you to then separate the tracks and do this effect. But in this tutorial, I'm going to actually use some videos that I imported and I recorded in another program. I recorded them in Camtasia. It's not a problem. It doesn't make any difference. You can still use the Descript one. So in my media bin at the top, I have three files. The screen recording. If I click on it, you can see my screen recording here. I've got the audio file with the sound, and I've got my camera, my webcam. And as you can see, I have a green screen behind me. I painted my wall green. This is not essential for this particular tutorial because we won't care about the green screen so much. We just care about how to put the head in a circle. So let's have a look. Before I can do this, I have to assemble my files into a sequence, so they have to play at the same time. So to do that, I select one, and then hold down Shift to select all three of them. And then in the bottom there, you can see Create Sequence. So I'm going to click Create Sequence. This is my sequence. It has the three tracks all synchronized and aligned. I've got the camera, I've got the audio. I'm just going to rename this audio. And then I've got the screen. I'm going to rename this screen. By default, Descript gives them the name of the file. So I need to mute the screen because it has a recording as well on it, the same audio. So I'm going to click on it and mute it like this. Press here to mute and click done. So that's my sequence. And I can find this one again in the media bin right there in the folder called sequences. There it is. And now I can add this to my composition right there. So I've got this blank composition. And here's my video. Now, if I close this media bin, you can see the two tracks appear as separate layers in Descript. And this is happening always in Descript. If you have a multi-track sequence and then you create or add that sequence to a composition, the tracks that are video in that sequence are actually made available to you as different layers right there. And you can move them around. You can see I can click each one of them and move them around. And if I click outside of the canvas area and I look on the right side, I see both of those tracks as layers now, camera and screen. That's all I need. And this is what you get also if you record using Descript's recorder. You get these two files already assembled in a sequence ready for you to do this. So I've got my composition here, and how can I achieve the talking head effect? Very easy. I'm going to take the screen and fill the screen with it. So that layer with the screen on it, I'm going to just place it in the corner and resize it to fill my screen like this. Then I'm going to take this layer, which is my video stream, and this is going to play at the same time as the video. So they're all staying synchronized. If you look in the timeline at the bottom, you only see one track. That one track is the sequence and they both play. If I make a cut or a change in my clips, they both get cut together. So there's not going to be any loss of synchronization. Let me make this one a talking head circle. How do I do this? It's important that, you know, if it's a circle, obviously it has to be round and it has to be a perfect circle, not like an oval or a ellipse kind of shape. So the way to achieve that is to ensure that this video is square. So if I click on it, you can see that it's not actually a perfect square. And in fact, you can check that if you look on the right sidebar here under layout, if you open this layout, you will see that it's actually wide. It's 823 pixels wide by 617. So all I have to do is make sure that I have these in a perfect rectangle first. So I will take the lock off. So this little link here shows me that the two dimensions are locked so that if I change one of them, both of them change. You see, I click and drag and they both change so the video doesn't, you know, lose aspect ratio. But what I want to do is I want to take this lock off and make them both the same size because I want to make it a square. So I'm going to put here, and it really doesn't matter what you put. Let's do 400 and let's do 400 on the other one as well. So 400 by 400, that's a perfect square now. I can put the link back on. And of course, if my head is now too small, I can make that larger by, let me just make some more room in here. And you can do that by double clicking and you go into crop mode and then pull this at the top here, 100% zoom. I'm going to make it larger, kind of like this, 159. And then you can also move it up or down. So you have freedom to move this inside of that clipping mask, or whatever you want to call that, the rectangle so that your head is kind of in the middle. And now press here to accept. Now for the talking head circle, right? The way to do that is you need to go to layout again, and you have the rounded corner in here. So the key is that the rounded corners have to be at least 50% of one of the sides. So since my sides are 400 by 400, the rounded corners have to be at least 200. You can do them, you know, you can make them more. It's not going to do more, but it's just going to make it perfect circle. Here we go, 200. There you go. You have a perfect circle now, because it's half of the sides, so each of the corners goes as high as half. So there you go, resulting a circle. So there is my head in a circle effect. You can move that down to the corner if you want, and you can also flip it. If I'm facing outwards, okay, this is how my camera recorded it, I can click here to flip like this. So I'm looking inwards now. So this is one way to do it. Of course, you can add effects to this, like a drop shadow if you want to. Click effects, and you can't add a drop shadow to a video, but you can put a circle behind it and add a drop shadow to that one. A little quirk in Descript. So what if I want to lose my green screen? Of course, if you have a green screen and record with green screen, you can use the effect here under the effects. Click plus and apply a chroma key to the video. By default, the chroma key is going to replace the green color, and my green screen is green. So click on this and look, my background disappears and I can now see the video behind. Okay. Now this looks a little odd because I have no kind of frame, no reference. I'm just like a bust kind of showing there. So what I would do is I would put a circle behind it. And to do that, you go to the top where the shapes are and let's choose an ellipse. There it is. And I'm going to resize this. Hold down the shift key to resize it proportionally when you drag, and let's put this behind my video. Now, if it's on top of the video, right click and say layer order and say move backward like this. And you may have to resize it a little bit just to make sure that it fits, you know, with the same size. You can use the arrow keys, by the way, to move these around. And if it's hard to edit like this, you can also open the layout here with that circle selected, and you can click and drag width and height, you know, and make it larger or smaller. And this one, it seems that I forgot to press shift at some point because it's lost. The dimension is not equal. So the width is actually wider. I can take off the link and just put 400. Because that was my video, and 400 here as well. So now it's a perfect circle. Put the link back on, and now let's click on this to move it and match like this with the bottom. Very nice. So now I can actually select this, select layer, select ellipse, and I can change the color, you know, using the fill controls. I can make it red, I can make it black, I can make it white. I can use one of these colors. I like this kind of orange, maybe. That's nice. And of course, you can add another effect to it, like a border, right? So I can add a border, and let's make the border white. And let's make it thicker like this from here. You can, you know, click on this number and drag, and there's your border right there. So I've got a very nice talking head. And look, if I'm playing now, everything should play in sync. There you go. So this is how you create a talking head. Make sure that the corner is at least half of the video cropping area, and make sure the video is cropped to a square so that it's equal sides and your circle is perfect. If the sides are not equal, just to show you what might happen, if the sides are not equal, then your circle is no longer a circle. You know, the sides in here, if I take off the chroma key, you see it's no longer a circle because you are, you know, it's not 50% of the sides. So that's one thing that might go wrong there. So let's put that back on there. So one final tip for you, if you want to have a tutorial or a video where you switch from this talking head video back to you full screen, back to just screen, back to the talking video, this is achieved with scenes in Descript, right? So let's suppose that halfway through, I'm going to actually do more, but halfway through, you want to go full screen, just you. You go to that place and you press slash to insert a scene, and then you go inside of that scene and say, you know what, in this scene, number two, I don't want to be in a talking head circle. So I'm deleting this, and I'm taking this off, and I'm taking off the chroma key, and I'm taking off the border from my video. Okay, so border is going to be zero. There you go. And I'm actually going to resize my video to be full screen. I know it's going to look odd because it's all with the green screen thing, but look, this is me full screen. And I'm going to just fill the screen like this with this. Okay, double click to place it like this. Sometimes, look, Descript has a bug where you press and the video keeps moving left. All you do now in that situation, just right click and say reset crop. And that's going to reset the crop back to what it was. So this is my video full screen, right? So that's another scene, scene number two. And they, look, first scene, I'm a talking head in a circle. And as soon as I go into the other scene, if I zoom in here just to make it faster, look how the scene changes. Here we go. I am full screen now. And if I want to go back to that layout where I am in a talking head, I go halfway here, maybe again, press slash to create a scene. And this is very easy. In this scene, I want to replicate what happens in the first scene. Very easy. You just right click on the first scene. Here at the top, you have the scene thumbnails. At the top, right click on that scene and say copy, and then go to that scene, the number three scene where you want to be back in the talking head, and right click on that thumbnail and click paste. There you go. You've replicated that layout from the first scene to the third one. And you can actually replicate these as many times as you like. If you decide to introduce a little talking head in the circle in the middle here, just press slash like this. Press slash again. So I created a short scene where I want to be in the talking head. Again, this has become scene number three. And I can go on the right click on the thumbnail and paste. Boom. There's my talking head layout. So you can switch back and forth like this between scenes and have different layouts, because scenes control layouts. So you can have any element showing, not only showing and hiding itself, but also showing in a different place, in a different, you know, position and different attributes all through each scene. And further, you can save these scenes as templates so that you can apply them from your templates to your next tutorial video. But that's a subject for a new video some other time. So there you have it. This is how you achieve in Descript a talking head video. I know that this was a long video because along the way, I've given you more tips on how to construct a sequence, how to assemble them, how to change the tracks, how to turn them on and off, and all these things. So I hope this tutorial was helpful, and thank you for watching. And by the way, if you are just now learning Descript Storyboard, I have a complete course on Descript Storyboard, the first course ever, that you can get, you know, in the description, there's the link. You can sign up for the course. There are some free sessions in there you can watch, and particularly one on the differences between the storyboard and the classic, the old version, and what's changed. So in case you didn't know that, or you're coming from the classic version, then that video is for you. And if you would like one-on-one help, I also provide one-on-one coaching for Descript. And make sure you sign up for the coaching in the description. There's the link for that, and all the details are there. So thank you again for watching, and I will see you in the next one.